All set, we're ready to go, so let's get the car out onto the track. Lap of fuel remaining. Confirmed, we'll receive you at the end of this lap. We'll be right back. So our fastest lap is a 1:21.0. Checks complete. Everyone be aware, we've got a car leaving the garage. To go.
Only a handful of tracks inspire as much adoration and nostalgia in the hearts of F1 fans as this one. This historic circuit awaits you. Welcome to Monza for the Italian Grand Prix. We're 12 miles northeast of Milan for today's Grand Prix at a Monza circuit where we can expect top speeds of around 215 miles per hour. 11 corners on this 3.6-mile track, with seven of those coming in the form of chicanes. And with a good slipstream and DRS open, there should be plenty of opportunity for some passing here today. So with the race not far away from starting, here's what today's grid rundown looks like. So with the race not far away from starting, here's what today's grid rundown looks like. Max Verstappen put in a fantastic lap yesterday, and he'll start from pole position. And it's Fernando Alonso alongside. As we continue through the rest of the grid today, we have Leclerc, Norris, Hamilton, Albon, Russell, Oscar Piastri, Tsunoda, Perez, Sainz, Ocon, Stroll, Hülkenberg, Gasly, Bottas, Sargeant, Magnussen, Joe, and Nick De Vries. It's almost time for those five red lights to go out then. Let's see who can prevail today. Anthony Davidson will be sharing his insight alongside me once again today. What should we be looking out for, Ant? Now, can I get your take on Max Verstappen?
Well, it was a really impressive lap in qualifying to get pole position, but are they going to be able to hold on to the lead into the first corner with so many quick starters around them? One more thing to consider is the strategy element. How far can the drivers push these tyres, and who's going to blink first for fresh rubber? It'll be interesting to see if the leaders have to compromise their plan to cover off the cars behind them.
Okay, so everything looks good on the power unit cycles, so let's concentrate on bringing tyres and brakes up to temperature. DRS now available. Back. Okay, good work. Great pass. Back battery charge is high, let's use that overtake button a bit more. Stopping this lap. Okay, mate, we might need to look at a new race strategy after that. I've got some options for you, so go and check your MFD. Got that, confirmed. Go! Perfect job on the turn in there, mate. Looks like a nice stop time. We're happy with that one. Up to speed now. Let's get some heat into those tyres. Car ahead is 29.1 seconds. Copy that. Time is a 1:24.0. We don't have the data for that, I'm afraid. Gap that we're trailing the car ahead by 20.3 seconds. trailing our teammate by 31.8 seconds. They're on old mediums. They're currently sixth. Time last lap was a 1:27.5. Okay, keep an eye on that gap ahead, please. 18.0 seconds. Safety car, no overtaking, reduce your pace. Keep your delta number positive as we form up. Right, drop your speed, our delta's too low and we're going to risk a penalty. Slow your pace immediately. Perfect job from you and the crew there, mate. We're delighted with that. Look after these tyres now. We want to finish the race on this compound. Right, the safety... Alexander's in the pits. Alexander in the pits. Right, drop your speed. Our delta's too low and we're going to risk a penalty. Slow your pace immediately. hard tyres. Car ahead now on the hard compound. Okay, let's get ready to go racing again. The safety car is in this lap. When the field accelerates, remember there's no overtaking until the timing line. Safety car in this lap. Managing your tyres, manage your tyres. Green flag. Let's use overtake and burn off some of this energy. Maneuver. You made it look so easy. Okay, we lost the position. Try to keep focus. Track is clear, green flag. Okay, information on Bottas. Okay, they're out of this race. We'll be right back. job. Nice overtake. I've got a brand new race strategy on your MFD if you want to go and check it out. Understood, copy that. Okay, off we go, back into the race. That was a fantastic stop, faster than we were expecting. So far. Okay, so the gap to the car ahead, 11.3 seconds. We'll be right back. Great work. That's a new fastest lap of the race. Trailing our teammate by 26.5 seconds. Nice move. Keep going. Gap ahead is 3.9 seconds. Gap on the car behind by 5/10 a lap. We'll be right back. gap to the car in front is 2.1 seconds. Front is less than 1 second now. Well done. Let's try and get past in the DRS zone. Nice move, keep going. No tyre concerns at the moment, just focus on the driving. Let's go. Final lap. Okay, just two laps of fuel remaining now. Okay, pick up rubber and bring it home.
It was a magnificent race and a drive right out of the top draw to take the win for Red Bull today. Tell me, Ant, how do you think they were able to deliver such an incredible result today?
I really feel the track layout combined with the track temperatures we saw today suited their car. These cars come alive when the tyres are just at the right temperature, and the driver did a great job managing that as well. They just look so comfortable out there. It's like anything, it always looks so easy when it all just clicks.
Red Bull are our winners today after showcasing some incredible driving. There's been a huge push from them lately to stay competitive with the other teams, and they're certainly proving themselves. So then, it's time to see how this result affects the Drivers' Championship. Max Verstappen should be pleased with his performance, making gains at the top of the table. Well, after an incredible day of racing, who was your driver of the day, Ant?
Max Verstappen seemed to just effortlessly weave through the other drivers today without a care in the world. He was definitely my driver of choice.
It's time to check out the constructors' standings. And pulling further ahead in the standings, it's Red Bull. Well, what an end to another fantastic weekend of racing. Thanks to everyone who joined us, and we'll see you for the next one.